Hello friends, welcome back to our video lecture series on course titled Fluid Mechanics 2. This is our 25th lecture, and in this lecture we are going to discuss water hammer and numerical on it. So as we have discussed in the previous lectures, we have considered two cases. The first, what is water hammer? Water hammer is the phenomenon in which pressure rise will be takes place due to the sudden decreasing velocity of the water to the zero. So that means that we are bringing the flowing water to the rest condition by closing the valve. It may be a suddenly or gradually. So due to that, whatever the kinetic energy available in the water will be get converted into the pressure energy, and pressure suddenly start to rise, and that sudden pressure rise will create a pressure wave which is going to travel in the upstream direction. And that pressure wave create a hammering effect on the pipe wall, and that's why this phenomenon is known as water hammer. So we have considered two cases, when the valve has been closed gradually and when valve has been closed suddenly. So in case of gradual closure of the valve, the equation of the P, pressure intensity or pressure wave, intensity of the pressure wave is given by rho V L upon T, where the V is the velocity, L is the length of pipe, and T is the time taken to close the valve, P is the intensity of pressure in Newton per meter square. Again, in case of instantaneously closure of the valve, this equation will be given by rho V C. So this is the equation in case of instantaneous closure of the valve, where V is the velocity again and C is the velocity of pressure wave. So let's we will solve some numerical on this. So in a pipe of 600 mm diameter, so diameter of the pipe is given, and 300 meter length, provided with a valve at its end, and water is flowing with the velocity of 2 meter per second. Assuming the velocity of pressure wave is 1500 meter per second, then find the rise in pressure if the valve is closed in 20 seconds, and the rise in pressure valve if valve is closed in 2.5 seconds. There are two values of the T is given, so we need to calculate rise in pressure twice for the T is equal to 20 seconds and T is equal to 2.5 seconds. Another, assume pipe is to be rigid one, so no need to consider the elasticity of the pipe. So our equation will be the purely what we have discussed just now, and take bulk modulus of water as 2 giganewton per meter square. So just first thing, write down all the given data, and what we need to find pressure intensity of the pressure intensity or pressure rise due to the valve closing. Now first we need to determine whether valve has been closed gradually or instantaneously. Now we know that we can determine that by using the ratio of 2L upon C. Now if the value of this 2L upon C is greater than T, then it is said to be gradual closure, and if it is less than T, then it is said to be instantaneously close of the valve, where T is the time taken to close the valve. So let's move towards the solution. The first thing, we need to determine whether valve has been closed gradually or suddenly. So first calculate 2L by C, which is coming out as 2 multiplied by 3000 divided by 1500. So 4, which is greater than T, is equal to 20 seconds for the first case. If we are considering the first case where T is equal to 20 seconds, then in that case ratio is less than the T, that means that T is greater than the value of ratio, that we can say that valve has been closed gradually. Now in case of gradually closure of the valve, our intensity of the pressure can be calculated by using P rho L V upon T. By putting all the values, our value of the pressure intensity is coming out as 300 kilonewton per meter square. This is the value of pressure wave. In case of gradually closure of the valve, when time taken for the closing valve is 20 seconds. Now let's move to the next. When time taken for the closing valve is 2.5 seconds. Now bulk modulus of water is given, K is equal to 2 giganewton per meter square. Now the first, you should calculate the value of C for this case, which is given by the equation C is equal to under root of K divided by rho, that is K is the modulus of elasticity of the water and rho is the density. So we are getting here 1414.2 meter per second. Now calculate 2L upon C. Why we have calculated this C separately? Because in this equation we are going to make use of that C. In this equation it is given as rho V C. So here we are going to use that C, And for that, we have used this bulk modulus of water, because in this case, our some strain energy is going to be stored in the water. So we need to consider this in case of instantaneous. So once we calculate this T, which is coming out as 4.24 second, so which means that it is greater than the T, or T is less than the value of this ratio. That means that valve has been closed instantaneously. Now, for the instantaneous closure of the valve, pressure intensity is given by the equation P is equal to rho V C. Just by putting the values, all the respected values, rho V C, velocity is 2 meter per second, density is 1000, and value of the C just now we have calculated 1414.2 Newton per meter square. So our answer of the pressure intensity or pressure rise in case of suddenly or instantaneously closing valve, or when T is equal to 2.5 second, is 2828.4 kilonewton per meter square. Hope you understood this. Let's move to the next numerical. In this case, water is flowing in the pipe of 150 mm diameter. Again, diameter is given, with the velocity of 2.5 meter per second. And when it is suddenly brought to the rest by closing the valve, here itself it is mentioned that it is suddenly brought to the rest. So no need to mention time separately. Here in the statement itself given that valve has been closed instantaneously or suddenly. Now find the pressure rise assuming pipe is elastic. In the previous case we have assumed that pipe is rigid. In this case pipe is elastic, and having modulus of elasticity is given as 206 giganewton per meter square. Again, Poisson's ratio is also given for the pipe material, 0.25, and bulk modulus of water is given as 2.06 giganewton per meter square. Now pipe wall is given as 5 mm thickness. They asked to calculate, find the pressure in pipe, pressure rise in pipe, or will intensity of pressure wave. So just write down the first given data. D is equal to 0.15 meter, thickness of the pipe 0.005 meter, velocity 2.5 meter per second, modulus of elasticity 206 giganewton per meter square, K is given as 2.06 giganewton per meter square, here it is point, and Poisson's ratio 1/4, that is 0.25. Now we know that in case of instantaneously closure of the valve, equation is given by equation of the pressure intensity is given by P is equal to V under root of rho divided by 1/K plus D upon ET, where K is the bulk modulus of water, bulk modulus of elasticity of water, E is the modulus of elasticity of the pipe material, T is the thickness of pipe, D is the diameter of pipe, and V is the velocity of flow. Just by putting all the values, we will get the required answer of the P. Here it is 2.5, velocity, density is 1000, density of water. Bulk modulus of elasticity of water is given 2.06 × 10⁻¹. Here bulk modulus of elasticity of pipe material is given as I think here it is a print mistake, it's 206 × 10⁹. That is 206 giganewton multiplied by 0.005. So just we have taken this 10⁹ common, taking it on numerator. Here it is coming as 10⁻¹ divided by 1 divided by 2.06, and here it is 0.15 divided by 2.06 multiplied by 0.005. So here it is the respected value of those ratios. By putting that value, by taking under root, I am getting your value for the P is equal to 3148 kilonewton per meter square. This is our required answer by when we are considering the elasticity of the pipe, or when we are considering elastic pipes. Hope you understood those two numericals. Solve some more numericals to get a better understanding about it. Those are the references which I have used for the preparation of my presentation. Thank you for watching.